How can you possibly say she looked better with the dark hair?
She did. The blonde just seemed like she was trying to be her sister.
The dark hair makes it look like she's trying too hard not to look like her sister. Plus, she does not have the nose for dark hair.
What does that mean?
Dark hair is like a giant light-up arrow pointing to what is wrong with you. Blonde hair, it all sort of blends in a haze of beige.
Nuts. You're nuts.
You're double nuts!
All right, that's it. No more spaghetti and meatballs. Musappa, come get these plates.
Mom!
Every time we have spaghetti and meatballs, you fight.
No, we're not fighting. We're just bonding.
Grandma, I'm starving.
Take these away. Mr. Gilmore's also.
Mom, come on. We won't fight anymore.
No, spaghetti and meatballs is just too much excitement.
I'm sorry about that. I left work early today, and apparently that caused everyone's IQs to drop 60 points. My food is gone.
Girls are fighting.
Well, I told you not to serve spaghetti and meatballs. They always fight when we have spaghetti and meatballs.
That's not true.
We fight just as much when we have Chinese food.
Can we please talk about something besides food?
Starvation, scurvy, the Donner Party.
I'm having LASIK surgery on my eyes.
Excellent topic.
LASIK surgery, why?
Well, I hate wearing glasses, so I found the best doctor on the East Coast, made an appointment, and I'm going in tomorrow.
Personally, I like you with glasses.
It's that whole dirty librarian thing, right, Dad?
I beg your pardon.
Three of the girls in my DAR group had it done already. I'm actually very excited about it. I got Dr. Morris.
The LASIK man.
From Dr. Sugarman, who is my ear, nose, and throat man, and he said Dr. Morris is brilliant and very, very handsome.
You never told me this.
Well, he just threw it in at the end of the visit.
I think that's incredibly unprofessional.
Oh, Richard, he just was saying the man is handsome.
Well, yes, as if it's a selling point.
It can be.
Hardly. Everyone knows ugly men make the best doctors.
That's absurd.
It's a fact.
Marcus Welby was handsome, and George Clooney.
Fake doctors, Mom.
Well, I'm sure they were modeled after real doctors.
I don't want to talk about this anymore.
He's jealous of Dr. Handsome.
I'm not jealous of Dr. Handsome.
I should go shopping for something new to wear.
You are not going shopping to get something new to wear to Dr. Handsome.
Everyone is a little testy tonight.
Maybe she was right about the spaghetti and meatballs.
Well, let's just talk about something else. We had lunch with Christopher yesterday.
Lunch.
We took him to the club.
Okay, but why?
Because there had been a lot of tension between us about the tuition incident, and your mother and I thought it was time for a sit-down.
A sit-down? What, did you get Clemenza to hide a gun in the bathroom first?
We thought it was time to clear the air. After all, Christopher is Rory's father, and we wanted him to know there were no hard feelings.
Really?
Don't get me wrong, we're still not happy about the situation, but since he's going to be involved in our lives now...
Whoa, involved in your lives? How is he involved in your lives?
Well, he's paying for Rory's college.
Yeah, but is he using your pen to write the check?
Of course not.
Then I don't see how he's involved in your lives. He's involved in her life, but...
Lorelai, will you relax? The lunch went fine. It was very pleasant, and Christopher enjoyed it.
That's right. He apologized for everything.
He knows that we're no longer angry with him, and we are all friends again.
Well, friends like these.
And after lunch, your mother and I began discussing what we were going to do with all the money that had been allotted for Rory's tuition.
And we came up with a brilliant idea.
Oh, yeah? What?
We're going to add some funds from our foundation and donate the total amount to Yale University in your name.
What?
That's right. And we'll make sure it goes for something really important, like a medical building.
For really handsome doctors.
Whatever it is, I want her name big and prominent.
My name?
The Rory Gilmore Political Science Building.
The Rory Gilmore Anthropology Building.
Guys?
The Rory Gilmore Cultural Center.
The Rory Gilmore Auditorium.
Can I interject for just a second?
Go ahead, I dare you.
While I think it's very generous of both of you to want to do this for me...
The Rory Gilmore Observatory.
I still go to Yale, so having something with my name on it might be kind of...
The Rory Gilmore Center for International Affairs.
Oh, wait. The Rory Gilmore Library.
An art gallery.
An ancient history museum.
Forget it, kid. Grandma and Grandpa have gone bye-bye.
The Rory Gilmore Medical Research Laboratory.
Now that sounds like monkey testing. People will pick it.